this everyday world, but you can be in a place where there is no you and still perceive the world. That scared me. Losing my ego was the scariest thing I ever, and I still don't like it.
A profound state which may be reached by use of these entheogens, psychedelics, hallucinogens, whatever you're going to call them, which is known as ego loss or ego death. Unfortunately, subsequent to the coinage of this term, ego has come to be used in a completely other sense. It has been used in the sense of pride, and that is not what ego death is about.
I mean, ego death would mean you lose your sense of I for good, and that's not what happens. They mean a temporary suspension of the ego when ego death is spoken of.
Ego death means the death of you as a concept, whereas we walk around thinking of ourselves as things. We think of, I am sitting in the chair, therefore, you know, I am a thing, the chair is a thing. When we reach the realm of ego death, or ego dissolution, or whatever you're going to call it, there is no longer any perceived boundary between oneself and the chair. In this state, there are no things. There is just one continuous experience.